is a 14-room, two-floor penthouse condo with a multi-million dollar view overlooking Vancouver's Cole Harbour and the North Shore Mountains. How many multi-millions are we talking about? Well, the property just sold for $25 million. Joining me now from our Toronto studio is condo developer Brad J. Lamb. He's broker president of Brad J. Lamb Realty Incorporated. We have some pictures to share, Brad. Tell us a little bit more about this property. What is so special about this condo?
Well, I mean, it's a very large condominium. It's 6,400 square feet. It overlooks Cole Harbour, the North Mountains. The view is one of the best views, you know, on the planet. It's a very luxurious property in a high-end five-star hotel in Vancouver on the waterfront. Listen, it's a huge price, $4,000 a square foot. It represents one of the largest, the highest prices ever paid for a condominium in Canada, and it actually rivals pricing in New York, London, and Hong Kong.
No kidding. Let's talk about the total cost of this, though, because when you add up condo fees, taxes, etc., it makes for a hefty mortgage payment or monthly payment, although I'm pretty sure there's no mortgage taken out on this one.
Probably not. Yeah, the condominium fees are $4,000 or $5,000 a month, and the property taxes are close to $70,000, which is probably on the low side for a $25 million sale. They'll probably get a tax increase next year.
Ah, well, they'll have to budget for that, won't they? This condo was on the market for almost 2 years, though, 650 days. Is that relatively typical for a luxury property of this kind?
It is. The number of buyers that could afford this is a handful, certainly in Canada, and likely a foreign buyer. I mean, listen, in Toronto, last year, 270 condos sold for more than $1 million. That's it. And so far this year, about 110 condos have sold for more than $1 million. So $25 million represents a very big number and a very select wealthy buyer.
Sure. Now, I know the realtor who held this property wasn't giving up too much about who the buyer might be. What have you heard about this particular buyer? We are assuming it is an offshore buyer. Do you have any other information?
Well, you know, I don't have any more information. To be honest with you, these kind of sales are usually done in a cloak and dagger fashion. It's hard to penetrate the veil of secrecy. But in the past, we've seen bank chairmen in Toronto spend $17-18 million on a penthouse. It's not that uncommon for a penthouse like this to sell to a Canadian multimillionaire. It's possible it could be a local, but more than likely now, I believe it's probably going to be a foreign buyer.
Wow. All right. Well, let's do a quick flip at the other end of the market, the entry level, because I wanted to ask you, there is some concern that the rules have been tightened up and there are predictions of a lot less new construction and concerns about Toronto even thinking of a new tax on developers of new construction. So what is that doing to the lower end market?
Well, the good news is that the MLS system is reporting very robust sales in April and May. In fact, April was the second best history of Toronto, and May is shaping up to the second or best May in history of Toronto. So it looks like the real estate economy in Toronto is shaken off the doldrums from that probably started May of last year, and we're on to bigger and better things again, I believe.
All right, well, we appreciate you coming on and talking to us about this. This is Brad J. Lamb, is broker president of Brad J. Lamb Realty. Thank you.